There are no virtues in the Shadowfell. Thanks to the Balhannoth, even hope is punished with death. We have arrived in a place surely forsaken by all things holy. Not 10 feet into the Shadowfell did we feel all hope of success leave our hearts. Another 10 feet and some creature garroted Valin, dragging him to the depths of an unseen lair. Uneager to lose more of my force, I gave the order to press on. We encountered emotions incarnate: loneliness, wretchedness, anger, hunger, and the lust. They wreaked havoc on our already beleaguered force. Curse this wicked place! Last night, I received a vision of our destination. I feel hope rekindled in my body for the first time since arriving in the Shadowfell. We move at first light. What fools we were! That cave was a trap long before we entered. I should have known. This wretched place, it appeared to us as our deepest desires. Sumas and I saw the lost temple of Lathander with relics we desperately sought. Opash saw an inn. Grav found a library. So grateful were we in our find that we failed to see the obvious hints of deception. The fabled shield of Lathander was worthless. The books Grav found were empty and Opash's beds were hard as rock. Suma suddenly screamed and vanished, taken by a horrid monster. The illusions began to fade and we saw it clear as day. A horrible creature with a gaping maw and reaching appendages. It ripped Sumas's head off before it ensnared Opash and Grav. I fled for my life, but discovered I lost my way and tried to hide. My rations ran out 3 days ago and my water will run out tonight. I can hear the creature hunt, trying to find my hiding spot. It sends me more images of the lost temple, but I know them to be lies. I have prayed to Lathander for mercy. He is silent, leaving me to my fate. Curse the gods. Welcome back to A Compendium of Monsters. This week's entry, the Balhannoth. Before we continue, please make sure you've subscribed to my channel. It helps me out a lot. Balhannoths are challenge level 11, large-sized aberrations. They have an armor class of 17, average hit points of 114, a speed of 25 feet, a climbing speed of 25 feet, and blindsight out to 500 feet. Balhannoths understand deep speech, have limited telepathy out to 1 mile, and are immune to the blinded condition. It is important to note that Balhannoths do not speak. They communicate via illusions, which I'll talk about in a moment. Balhannoths have 2 uses of the legendary resistance trait, meaning the Balhannoth can choose to succeed on a saving throw it would otherwise fail. Balhannoths have a flexible multi-attack that allows them to choose between 2 options. A Balhannoth can make a bite attack and 2 tentacle attacks, or it can forego the bite attack and make 4 tentacle attacks. The bite attack deals roughly 25 damage per hit, but the tentacle attacks get messy. Each tentacle has a range of 10 feet and will grapple the Balhannoth's target, forcing that target up to 5 feet closer to the Balhannoth. The Balhannoth can have up to 4 creatures grappled at once and can make attacks against grappled targets with advantage, as the targets are also restrained until they escape. Balhannoths have 3 legendary actions, meaning they can take an action at the end of an opponent's or ally's turn during the round. A Balhannoth can choose to make a bite attack, choose to vanish and become invisible for up to 10 minutes unless it attacks, or choose to teleport. If it teleports, the Balhannoth moves with any equipment and creatures it is carrying up to 60 feet into an unoccupied space it can see. Balhannoths are powerful enough to merit their own lair actions and regional effects. Starting with lair actions, a Balhannoth can take 1 of 3 following non-consecutive actions on initiative count 20. A Balhannoth can warp reality over the course of 10 minutes, affecting a 500 square foot area. This area reshapes itself to something an intelligent creature whose mind the Balhannoth has recently read desires most. Upon any inspection, the illusion starts to fall apart. Books contain only blank pages, objects of value are deemed worthless, etc. This transformation of the environment lasts until the Balhannoth dies or uses its lair action again. A Balhannoth can target 1 creature within 500 feet of it, forcing the creature to make a wisdom saving throw or be teleported to a space of the Balhannoth's choice within 60 feet of the Balhannoth. The Balhannoth will then spend its next action or legendary action trying to maul the creature it yoinked across the battlefield. For its last lair action, a Balhannoth can target a creature within 500 feet of it. This creature must make a wisdom saving throw or the Balhannoth becomes invisible to that creature for 1 minute. This effect ends if the Balhannoth attacks the target, but only then. If this isn't terrifying, let me give you a very possible scenario. You're fighting a Balhannoth who immediately goes invisible to your tank, who starts struggling to find it. The Balhannoth then forcibly teleports your healer or caster and takes a huge bite out of them. The tank still can't see the Balhannoth, but the Balhannoth uses its lair action again to make itself invisible to a 2nd damage dealer. If you're a 4-person party, half of you can no longer see the Balhannoth. The caster is most likely dead and probably grabbed
grappled, and the remaining unaffected party member is about to get messed up next. All the while, the Balhannoth is feeding on your despair, and then your bodies. For its regional effects, a Balhannoth warps the area around its lair. A creature that comes within 1 mile of the lair will experience one or both effects. The first effect causes a creature to experience a sensation of being close to whatever they desire most. The sensation grows stronger the closer the creature comes to the Balhannoth's lair. The second effect causes the Balhannoth to sense the strongest desires of any humanoid within 1 mile of it, and it learns whether those desires involve a place, a safe location to rest, a temple, a home, or other important location to that humanoid. If the Balhannoth dies, these regional effects end immediately, rather than up to 10 days post-mortem. Native to the Shadowfell, Balhannoths are vicious predators that use their special telepathy and reality warping abilities to snare unwary travelers. Balhannoths make their lairs near places inhabited by the creatures they hunt, meaning Balhannoths are typically found near well-traveled roads and paths. The Balhannoth hunts by sending telepathic images of what a creature desires most in a place to that creature. The Balhannoth then warps its nearby environment to match the prey's desired location as much as possible, but there are always some minor inconsistencies that may give away the deception. However, the illusion is usually good enough to fool desperate creatures into stumbling into the Balhannoth's clutches. Once a Balhannoth grabs its prey, it teleports away to devour that prey. Balhannoths thrive on fear and despair, giving it the ability to take pleasure in the horror its victims experience. However, this special kind of skills make Balhannoths valuable to none other than the Drow, who will go out of their way to capture Balhannoths. The Drow use Balhannoths as guardians, be it watching over passageways or even the many slaves every Drow house keeps. Anyways, what do you all think of Balhannoths? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, and share this video across your social media. I'll see you all next time.